man, put him into me. Everybody try to take the identity. Everybody around me turn to a friend of me. Sit back while I take on a remedy. I cannot let it get into me. This playing a toll on me meant to me.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. The time for talk is over as we are just mere moments from the Super Bowl. Two teams now have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Saints going up against the Browns.
Larry, this 2017 season has given us enough thrills to last a lifetime, and now only one game remains, and it's the one we've all been waiting for, as EA Sports is proud to welcome you to coverage of Super Bowl 52 from two-year-old U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told, as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Miller now off the play fake. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. 17 yards on the game's opening play and a quick first down. That's a matchup maybe they go back to their outer third of the field as this game continues.
Yeah, I think back to my high school coach, John Ford. He used to say when we got big plays early in a game or good plays, they say, foul it away, lad. Foul it away, because he wanted to move. Lad, yeah.
Off play action. Miller toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Back-to-back gains of 17, and they are really on the march now. It's a first down.
Here we go.
No escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly it.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Khalil Mack in there to get him, and this pass rush strong now. That sack's on back-to-back plays. Here's Miller, off play action. He's going to fire one deep over. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, New Orleans. With a first touchdown of this Super Bowl and a long one at that. And the Saints have taken the early lead. Striking first in any game is very important, but on this stage, the biggest of stages in the Super Bowl, that's huge.
You fully expect the other team to battle all the way through, but when you're the one setting the pace, jumping out in front, that has to feel great for the entire organization.
Now Damian Williams to return it. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Just shy of the 40. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
Well, partner, I have to say they caught him in the right defense there. Nickel set, fifth defensive back on the field, and they love to run against that because now you typically get a bigger blocker on a smaller defender.
Yeah, because those DBs like you, they want the interception. They're not as worried about the running play, right?
Not at all. And I still remember being in school, and one of my offensive line teammates used to say, boy, I'd love to come downfield and hit you little people.
Good run there. So second down, 3 yards to go now. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Looking to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 35. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. Now Miller, off the play fake. Dancing to his left. On target over the middle to Hill. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one goes for 36 yards.
Someone sharp in this game. He had a touchdown pass in the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
A really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
I was really impressed with that last practice we saw. When they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations, ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one. I know in every game we do, we talk about momentum. That didn't get the interception.
Yeah, you could almost hear the collective gasp on the sideline as he could not come up with that football. And this one's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Tyreek Hill that time. And it's third down.
All right, Captain. It's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodge two pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up on third and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we've just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in this situation, you kind of run.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they'll throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
And that one falls down.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he goes nowhere. He'll lose yardage back at the 17. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. On play action, they'll throw. Going up top. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
I know exactly why I tried to throw the ball to Julio Jones there. He's never considered covered. He's either too fast or too strong. You always try and get it to him.
Especially on those deep passes. Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. Fielded at about the 28. A good return there. 17 yards. And possession will switch hands. First and 10. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Off the play fake. Miller throwing the out route incomplete. It's Hill. A good pickup there of 20 yards. And that last reception puts him over 150 yards now on the game, Charles.
And now it's not just execution. It's not just performance. It's a mental aspect that's going on. Because right now, he's got the defense so much on their heels. Got them looking at each other. Who's going to cover this guy? And what type of coverage can we put out there to try and slow him down?
Miller looking to throw on second down. And that'll be incomplete.
I know for us it's fun, and it's not so much fun for the rookie receivers when we see them coming into the league and we're good at training camps. You see them working on getting 2 feet down instead of one. But the best ones train in college trying to get two down instead of one, so the transition's a little bit less. In this case, though, wasn't able to complete it anyway.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. And my goodness, this is incomplete. A disappointing drop there on fourth and goal. And this Browns defense stands tall. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. First down, he'll drop to throw it. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. And he will take this up to about the 8 yard line. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up third and nine. They'll look to throw here. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he'll be brought down around the 7 yard line. They had him back deep, got the interception, and now they start inside the 10.
Partner forgets starting inside the red zone. They're inside the green zone. From the 10 yard line in, a lot of teams call it that because that's the money zone. Get it into the end zone and make your cash.
And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Flushed out right. And he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Braxton Miller, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Saints add on to their lead.
He didn't originally want to run, but he didn't see anything in the passing game, so he scrambled. And wouldn't you know it, he scores a touchdown anyway. It's awfully nice to have a quarterback who can make things happen with his legs.
Here's Hopkins now for the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. Hopkins now out to kick it away. It's a very short kick taken by an up man. And now the Browns coming out on the field. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns earlier, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Willie Henry in there to get him for a loss of five. A rookie QB struggling, gets thrown down to the ground there. But, you know, maybe this game, it's not over yet, but maybe this game can be a learning experience for him.
So many different things that he has.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. And they will finally stop him as he's down to the 40-yard line. The rookie picked off the rookie.
And guess what? They're pretty familiar with each other. It's not like when I was growing up and the dinosaurs were roaming the earth and you heard about a guy somewhere. Now they run into each other at camps, going through high school ball, recruiting, college games, all-star games, you name it. A lot more familiarity with each other.
And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. And a nice gain of 21 yards. The Saints put up 29 points a game last year, second only to the Falcons, and they're in range to get some points on this drive as well. First and 10. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. A great play there. A three-yard touchdown run. And the Saints now add six to their lead. And it is now 21 to nothing. Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we're having a tough patch, this too shall pass, and finally we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something
heads up
to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and this shows on the scoreboard.
And once again, not much running room, if any at all. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. Now back to throw. He's going to float this over the middle, deep. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
I'm laughing to myself because I could just hear in film session, but coach, I was throwing to Odell Beckham Jr. Of course I thought he was open.
They'd love to go deep downfield to him, though. Such a threat.
Yeah, a rare incompletion because most of the time we expect him to actually come up with the catch.
They're going to try and
I done came up, busting down the whole broke, step back. Watch people swag. Ain't even gotta ask. What are those? What is that?
Now let's take a minute to see how you can improve your